welcome to Family Friendly New Orleans. And New Orleans, if you live around here long enough, you learn that there's three primary things in this culture here. You'll talk about football, music, or food. And that's the three main things surrounding the city of New Orleans. But the state of Louisiana is known as sportsman's paradise. And what most people, even New Orleans, may not even realize is that New Orleans actually has a rich history in boxing. You'll find some here that remember the fight between Sugar Ray Leonard and Roberto Duran. And others might still remember a fight at the Superdome between Muhammad Ali and Leon Spinks. But the boxing history in New Orleans goes back much further. And in fact, that's why I'm here in Kenner today, is to cover the first World Heavyweight Boxing Championship in history. It happened right here, just outside of New Orleans. So join me as we take a trip back to the years just prior to the year 1870. The primary fighting style for boxing was bare-knuckle boxing. Now, bare-knuckle boxing doesn't really bear any resemblance to the boxing that we do today. Obviously, it was bare-fisted instead of using boxing gloves, and also many wrestling techniques were used during it. In the prime of bare-knuckle boxing, there was a young prize fighter by the name of Gypsy Jim Mace. Now, Jim Mace was the accomplished fighter of his time in Great Britain, all the way up until 1869, where the Marquess of Queensberry changed the rules. And the rule change was intended to make boxing a more civilized sport, and many of the rules are still in place today, namely wearing boxing gloves, and they could no longer wear spiked boots in their fights. Well, this didn't sit so well with Jim Mace. He says, "I don't need your sissy mittens. I'm going to continue fighting the way I like to fight, and there's nothing you can do to stop me." Well, in 1869, Great Britain put a stop to Jim Mace by arresting him for fighting in an uncivilized manner. So after Jim was released from jail, he said, "I've had it enough with this civilized boxing style. I'm going to move to a lesser civilized country, the United States." And looks like they like to fight over there. They just finished their civil war. And I'm going to continue my boxing style in the United States. So Jim packed his stuff up and moved on over to the U.S. So in 1870, Jim Mace arrived in the U.S. and began fighting a series of exhibition fights. And soon thereafter, he got his eyes set on a young man that was the American boxing champion. And even though the name says American boxing champion, he was also a British fellow and who also enjoyed bare-knuckle boxing. And so they said, "Hey, let's get together and have the first world championship boxing match. American boxing champion versus British boxing champion." But they had to decide upon a place to do it. One of the places they thought about was New Orleans, because being that boxing was an uncivilized sport, let's go to one of the most uncivilized places in the country, a place where they love sin and debauchery. Let's go to New Orleans. Well, you know, one of the few things that New Orleans had outlawed was bare fist fighting. So if you wanted to box in New Orleans, you had one of two options. You could either put a barge out in the middle of the river and have your boxing match in the middle of the river to where the police can't really get to you or harass you. Or you could find a little rural place close to the river and set up a little makeshift boxing ring. And the two chose to do the latter of those two choices. So they went to the small town of Kennerville and set up a boxing ring at LaSalle Landing. And so here we are at LaSalle's Landing, the location of the fight between Gypsy Jim Mace and Tom, I'm too cool for a nickname, Allen. And here they fought for 10 rounds, equaling 44 minutes. Now, I'm not sure which boxer is which depicting on here. I believe Tom Allen was the taller of the two, so he might be the guy on the right. I don't know. Now, the way bare-knuckle boxing matches typically took place was you would do a series of rounds, and each round would typically end when one fighter would be taken to the ground. Now, whether that be through a wrestling move, whether that be through any other move by a knockout or something like that, that would typically end the round. Now the fight was 10 rounds and it lasted 44 minutes, which is a really, really long fight. And it ended when Jim Mace picked up Tom Allen and threw him to the ground. And his manager had thought that Tom Allen's neck might have been broken, so he threw in the sponge, thus ending the fight, naming Jim Mace as the world champion. Jim Mace, world champion of the world. Now, to those in attendance, it was reported that Tom Allen was pretty much manhandled through the entire fight by Jim Mace, that Tom took it like a champ for 44 minutes straight when he finally had to give up the championship to Jim. Now, the purse for winning the fight was $2,500. Now, that's a healthy chunk of change in 1870, and it roughly translates to about $42,000 today. So, old Jim could go out and buy himself a nice little suit and be happy. But this wasn't the end for Tom Allen. Tom Allen went on to continue to have a successful boxing career, although afterwards he adopted the more civilized boxing style with boxing gloves. I wonder if it was directly related to this fight or not. You decide. Now, if you enjoyed this video, make sure you like, share, subscribe. Make sure you try to find me on Facebook and Twitter. I'll put the links down below. And thank you for watching. Laissez le bon temps rouler.
But he don't say nothing, he just keeps rolling, he keeps on rolling along.
Smile, you're getting punched in the face.